Write down heading. Default constructor. Default constructor. This is the constructor. Which is meant for assigning the value of variables to default values. Then it is called as default constructor. Okay, now say, let me show you the program. See, basically, what is the use of constructor? Tell me.
To initialize variable and objects.
See, let's take an example of int some variable, okay? Which is public. Now what I will do, I want to call that particular variable. What I will do over here, a1 cout a1 dot sum. Okay, now what will be the output? See, 7588. What is that output? Some junk value it will take. Got it, right? Some junk value it will take. Where these kind of issues will come into picture whenever you are not initializing the variables. Okay? Say, if it is normal variables, it is okay. But pointer variables, all these things, if you are not initializing, it will create an issue. When we are dealing with the pointers, I said already, memory issues you will be facing. So, you should not leave that variables like that only. But it writes some default values you have to assign. How to assign a default value? Even though we are not assigning manually, automatically by making use of constructor, it should get initialized. How it will happen? Let me show you. See, this variable is there over here. And a constructor, it should not be private, so I am declaring under public. Constructor name and class name should be same. See, it is a function basically, but the difference between normal function and constructor is function name can be anything, but here this function name, constructor name, should be same as class name. Function can have void, into that, this and all, but here you should not have that. Return statement can be there, but here return statement should not be there. Same function you can define multiple times. I'll show you that example in inheritance. But here it is not like that. You can declare the variables within the constructor, within the function, but not in the constructor. This is constructor is meant for initialization, not for declaration. Clear? Let me show you. See, I will define sum equal to sum 10. I'll initialize it. Got it, right? Now you don't need to call that constructor. If it is a function, means you need to call specifically a1 dot sum, a1 dot display something, we need to call it. When it comes to constructor, you don't need to call it specifically. A1, if I say, automatically it will search for default constructor. If it is there, that block will get executed. if it is there. If it is not there, it will ignore. Not an issue. After executing that particular thing, sum got some value. What is that value?
10.
After that, if I print sum, what is the output?
10.
Yeah. Is that clear? Any doubts? Make a doubt. Okay. Now we are going to see how to define the default constructor or any constructor, not only default constructor, outside the class. Okay? Say, here class is there till here only, and constructor A brackets I have mentioned. That means somewhere this constructor is there. Where is that? You see here. This is the constructor which is a member of A class. What it is doing? It is initializing sum equal to 10. Is that clear? This is another way of creating constructor. This is outside the class, that is inside the class. Make a note. One sec. Let me stop this.